What are the best goggles? I think it's time for a goggle review. Let's go! Well, good day, fellas. Well, today I'm answering YouTube's biggest question. What are the best goggles? Now, back in the day when I was looking for goggles to buy, I didn't know what to do, didn't know what to get. This you couldn't find this anywhere. If you were, you were looking at a top 20 tier list of Amazon's best sellers, which everyone knows do not involve any arena or speedo goggles unless you're buying some massive things for scuba diving and go there. But these are for swimming goggles, for competitive swimmers, and the best ones you can get. And well, this should be the first video really you can get the best idea, and I'll give you my personal opinion of what my favorite goggle is and the one I race in, everything from a 50 to a 1500 consistently without fail. I'll rank them all at the end. I've got about like five different types of goggles here, and I'll tell you which one I prefer, which one's the worst, and what ones you should probably go for. I'll list the prices. So, you might as well get right into it. First off, I've got a load of goggles here. Might as well start off with not one that I see very often, but from a well-known brand. Tyr. It's not TYR, it's Tyr, like I said in the trailer. So here you go. Here are the Tyr Tracer Racer X goggle. Personally, they've got the biggest profile. So by profile, I mean they're the thickest. So that's decently big. The best thing about this goggle is that this gasket is the best thing you've ever seen. It's the most comfy gasket. So I reckon these are the training goggle, one of the best ones you can get. It just wants to be really, really comfy. Anti-fog isn't great. Literally, if you drop these once, lens are going to get screwed up. I'll show you what they look like on, they're nothing special. They haven't got any standout features other than that liquid silicone gasket, which I've got to say is really comfy. Like, you would not know that these are on. So you have got the new Arena goggles that just came out, which state you wouldn't even know that these are on. And I think these are comfier than those. So if you're looking for a really, really comfy training goggle, I wouldn't recommend these for racing, so I just don't think that they're too high of a profile for that. I reckon you go for the Tyr Tracer X. These are around 25 British pounds. So, and you can probably get them from Swim Outlet, Allen's of Kingsbury here in the UK. You can get these everywhere. Nice little goggle. I'd rank them last on my list because we have got a few bangers here. So, put them to a side. My next one, I have done a review on these already on the channel. That just go to the channel, look at the videos. Swedish goggles are the best bang for your buck you can get. Cannot stress this enough. It is a great training goggle. I've raced in these. Yes, they're high profile, but you can make them fit you perfectly as they're completely customizable and they're just great. I love them to bits. Here you go, here are the Tyr Tracer Racer X goggle. No, not Tyr Tracer X, Tyr Socket Rockets, right? I've been wearing these in my outdoor pool and they're splendid. They're UV protection, which means when the sun's in my eyes, I'm not burned into a crisp. They're really great, really comfy. They don't look that bad on. The mirror's great. Fog is brilliant on them, better than their latest goggle, which are the Tyr Tracer Racer X. That's got shocking anti-fog. This hasn't, although I've just been wearing it in the pool and I've only had it for like 2 odd weeks. They haven't worn out, haven't had to rub them. It's been great, fantastic. 10 out of 10 on a Swedish goggle, especially the Tyr Socket Rocket 2.0s. Now, this is where it gets really interesting. These are the goggles that you see at national champs, to world champs, to Commonwealth Games, the whole shebang. Now, you probably see, your mates probably have them, you probably have a pair. I think everyone has a pair of these. A Speedo Socket Rocket 2. I did have a pair of original Socket Rockets, but someone robbed them off me. If it was you, send me a DM. So I bought these. I got the pink pair, mainly because I saw Caleb Dressel wear them in the 53 at 2019 Worlds. I was like, oh my god, those are cool. In hindsight, I wish I went for the all blacks. It matches my suit a bit better. But, you know, these are really great goggles. I was training in these for a good 8 months before lockdown. Really comfy. I did find that the silicone gasket took easily about 6 sessions for it to, like, it was really hard. Like, I needed it to wear out and become a bit softer, because this was rock solid. The amount of goggle marks I'd have, it was painful. Especially I was going to school that day. I was training in the morning. Oh, it was horrible. It hurt my eyes. I just couldn't do it. But after about 6 sessions, this started to get a bit softer, and I can wear these around school. They're great, they're really soft. If you're someone that's into your peripheral vision and seeing your competitors, especially if you're racing in these, they're not great for that. But if you're not someone that's interested in that, great goggle, 10 out of 10. Definitely gonna buy another pair of these when it comes to the new season. But let's talk about Speedo's big, big flop. In my opinion, it's a shocking goggle. The Faskin Pure Focus. This goggle is shocking. Shocking, shocking, shocking. This came out starting at £50. And some people are selling them for £70. Yes, they've come in some different colours, but oh my god, these are awful. If you're picking up a pair of these, you know, as soon as you buy them, throw them away. You don't need them. They're so bad. I love Speedo and I've bought so many of their suits, but these goggles are shocking. Absolutely shocking. Right, yes, they're comfy, but this, see this? Great, right, okay. Great thought. Executed poorly, right? The MPXC goggles did this so much better. Speedo, I've tried to do this mainly because their previous goggle, the Faskin Elite, was known to be breaking at the nose bridge. But they tried to do this and it just hasn't worked. It was a great idea, it worked for the first couple weeks, and it just wore out and it just wasn't great. Along with something else worn out, the anti-fog, right? It was shocking. I don't know what was going on. I wore them twice. I wore them for two races. I bought them for a meet. Wore them for two races. Wore them for the 400 free. Then wore them for a 53. And then I got them for my 200 back. And I couldn't see a thing after 20 meters. Couldn't see a thing. These anti-fog was just, it was done. It was done. They've attempted this stabilizing bar. You can call it that. Oh, it just wasn't great. Oh, it was really, really sour. So if you are a big fan of Speedo, don't buy these. If you are, and if you're like me, I kind of ended up buying them for a collection just to say I've had a pair. But if you are going to get Speed Socket 2s for like £30, you can get them at Dolphin Swimwear here in the UK, or Allen's at Kingsbury, or order them offline off Swimwear Outlet or Pro Swimwear. Okay, so these rock bottom, okay, I forgot, I'm doing a tier list, aren't I? So these rock bottom worst goggles ever made. Okay, I'd say these, right, no, so after these, rock bottom, these are much better, but they're still not the best, too high profile, and I think Tier's latest, the brand new ones that I haven't got my hands on, are better than these, and I think these are good for training, but not great for racing, and that's why these are, how many goggles we got, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So six, so this placed 5th out of the 6 of the big names. Okay, and then obviously these ranked 4th. Obviously I love Swedish goggles. They were great. These were the go-to goggles back in like 1998 until even 2019. Like, you still people see rocking these, like Matt Reavers and Lily King and Sarah Sjostrom. You know, Bruno Fratus, if you know who he is, he's a great little sprinter over in Brazil and got silver at the World Championship. So you do see these rocking about, but I don't think it's good as some of the stuff we have now. Okay, and after that, in third, we have the Speedo Speed Socket 2.0s. Great goggle if you're on a budget, if you say, and these are like 30 quid. Get them, they're great, they're long lasting. As I said, had these 8 months, they stick to your face great. Anti-fog's great, not a problem. I'm probably gonna be wearing these on holiday when I go this year, so it should be really, really good fun. But here we go, the elite of the elite, the best goggles you can get. Now, some people say these are two different goggles. Some people say this is just the one goggle, but I see them as two different models. So, in second, we've got a busted up pair of Arena Cobra Ultras. These are the pink versions. Obviously, I snapped them, so I only have this. But, Arena Cobra Ultras, released in 2015, were the in thing. Like, everyone bought a pair of these. The stability bars were great. Anti-fog was great. They looked great. They were super low profile. They were really, really, really thin. Nose bridge didn't break. They were really, really trusty. You could dive in with these and know they weren't going to leak. It was just the best feeling ever. I remember when I bought my first pair, I just started racing. I was 10 years old and I was like, oh my God, I look so cool. This is before I started getting into my swimming. And I think like a year later, I saw Adam Peaty win Olympic gold. In the 100 breaststroke, wearing a black pair of these. And the first thing I did that day was go online, order a black pair, and make sure I had them next week for training. So, yeah, Arena Cobra Ultra's second best goggle in the world. Number one, my personal favourite goggle, is the Arena Cobra Ultra Swipe goggle. Now, the reason I think this is a completely different goggle in its own way, is that it's got a completely other colourways, the lenses are done different. Other than that, they're about the same, but I still think they're a different goggle, in my opinion. Let me talk you through it. So it's got the same profile, same pretty much everything, but this special thing here changed swimming. I know this wasn't the first goggle to implement it, but this is the first big name to do it, and therefore people are going to see it as the first people to do it. This, if you're swimming a distance event, if you're swimming a sprint event, you just want a trustworthy goggle that isn't going to fog, this is your go-to. The swipe lenses, it works great. All you have to do, you dunk them in the water, you wipe the lenses 3 times, which works fine, you rinse them out, put them back on. These aren't fogging for the rest of your session. And if they do fog for you, well, send me a message and tell me, because I don't believe you. I've got 2 pair of these. I've got a mirrored pair, a non-mirrored pair. As you know, that these are a mirrored pair, but this also says it's mirrored, but I don't think it is. You can see through them. These are mirrored and these are mirrored. So these ones are for indoor swimming. These ones for outdoor swimming, but I use them for both indoor because, well, I'm in Britain and there isn't much outdoor swimming. Anyway, these are the best goggles. Yes, they're a bit pricey, 40 quid from Allen's at Kingsbury, 50 quid on other places like Pro Swimwear, and can be a bit difficult to get your hands on. But these are definitely the best goggles in the world. You see everybody wearing them. Katinka Hosu, Adam Peaty, everyone's wearing these, everyone and their mother. I mean, my mum's 51 and she wears a pair of these when she goes training. So, yeah, everyone's wearing these. These are the best goggles you can get. Best ones I've ever worn. And I'll probably wear these for the rest of my career in swimming. And yeah, I've really enjoyed my time with them. And I'll leave a link in the description if you just go and buy yourself a pair. And yeah. Okay, on that note, I'll have to say goodbye, fellas. Make sure you like and subscribe with notifications turned on. So we're really trying to hit 50 subscribers within the next month and a half, because we're on 25. We've nearly got 100 followers on Instagram. It's the best. I think 50 subscribers, like, for ending up having a channel for 4 months, especially for the small following we have on Instagram anyway, would be absolutely outstanding. So please share this to everyone you know so we can get more likes, more subscribers, because we want that fame, boys. Right. I'm seeing you all. hope you have a lovely day, and I hope this video has helped you in some way or another. Make sure you go and cop yourself some of these goggles. Obviously, as I said, if you really are on a budget, get yourself a pair of Swedish goggles. But if not, get yourself a pair of either Arena Cobras or Arena Cobra Ultra Swipes, because they are the best goggles you'll ever have. And yeah, before I leave you on that note, adios amigos.